We often look up at the stars and feel at peace, but stars are actually insanely turbulent and chaotic celestial things, and we use that chaos to learn more about how our universe works. We've seen stars eat other stars, witnessed stellar flares, and white dwarfs on the verge of a supernova, but we haven't fully grasped what's actually going on inside the core of a star. Observing the interior of a star is pretty much impossible at the moment, so scientists are looking at a phenomenon happening on the surface of stars to better understand their internal structure, starquakes. Similar to earthquakes here on our planet, starquakes are tremors or waves that occur on neutron stars and other massive bodies. Most stars are balls of plasma, but neutron stars are super dense, so they have a crust. Neutron star crusts are 10 billion times stronger than steel. With these bodies, their crust and magnetic field are interconnected. So when a star rotates quickly, the crust is under pressure from gravity and that fast rotation, causing it to bulge out. If the structure keeps twisting, it can rip the crust open, and that creates a starquake. The resulting release of energy is vast, beyond our wildest imaginations. Starquakes are a reminder that space is violent and metal as hell. The biggest starquake ever detected was from a magnetar, which is such a badass name. They are a class of neutron stars with the most intense magnetic fields in the entire universe. One starquake on a magnetar released more energy in a tenth of a second than our sun does in 150,000 years. That is a metric shit ton of energy. If the explosion had been within 10 light years of us, experts say that Earth could have suffered a mass extinction. Whew. Another cool thing is starquakes emit frequencies that can be detected by the Kepler Space Telescope, and scientists did so and interpreted them for our ears. Cool, right? The reason astronomers looked into this is because some cosmologists believed stars were just out there. They weren't really organized. Starquakes were used to prove otherwise. In a recent paper, an international team of astronomers studied starquakes from 48 red giants in two ancient star clusters. And by measuring the waves from these starquakes, they found 70% of the stars had spins that were aligned with one another. It proved astroseismology could be a successful tool to understand the conditions of stars and discredited the theories that the stars were just randomly oriented. Studying the vibrations from stars is very similar to what seismologists do to understand the core of our own planet. For example, if you want to study the Earth's interior, we can't exactly like drill a hole down into the center and find out what's going on. Same thing goes with stars. We can't just go in and grab a piece of a star's core and study it. But the waves created by those quakes can be measured, and by measuring the oscillations coming to and from the center of a star, we can understand its physical conditions, the size of its core, and more about its origin story. It's pretty wild that we can use the internal hum of a star that's light years away to figure out how our universe formed billions of years ago. More research is happily needed. So next time you look up to the stars, remember you've actually got front row seats to a celestial magnetar concert. By the way, did you know stars are also related? Scientists found the family tree of our sun, and it turns out it's got siblings. Check out the fam here. Have a science question? Let us know down in the comments. Make sure you subscribe for more Seeker. Thanks for watching.